Welcome back to another episode of LA Mom Magazine. I'm here again with the fabulous Tamara Fabric, a licensed clinical social worker in Beverly Hills. And we are going to talk about keeping the passion alive with your partner after several years of being together, being married, having children. Everything kind of fizzles. So give us your great tips that you share with your clients.
Absolutely. I think one of the most difficult things is to balance being a family and being a couple and making sure that you put effort into the couplehood. It's certainly easier to do the family because you got little kids and they demand it.
Sure.
But keeping the romance alive and the passion alive with your partner is, I think, really non-negotiable, because if you don't have a good marriage, a good partnership, everything else
falls
around you falls apart.
Sure.
So there's a couple things that I'd recommend. Number one is date night. To me, date night should be once a week. It's something that you can either do with another couple, you know, or in a social event. But if you do that, you need to make sure that you also do things alone, just you and your partner.
Once a week.
Okay. The rule of thumb in my family is no talking about the kids on date night.
I love that. So date night, once a week, and no talking about the kids on date night. Fabulous.
Okay. I think another thing that's really important is what I call family meeting, and it's where once a week, we usually do it on Sunday nights, you sit down, you talk about the scheduling. What happens oftentimes with couples, with kids also who are juggling, you know, people have four children, who are juggling everything, is that many of the conversations end up being about scheduling and logistics, and you don't get to talk deeper. So if you meet once a week and you sit down with your calendar and you really talk about the logistics, then you have time throughout the week to talk about other stuff.
That's brilliant.
Which leads me to the next point, which is that it's really important once the kids are down to turn off the electronics and spend a little time just having a conversation, touching base, 15 minutes, 10 minutes. It doesn't have to be a long time.
So don't bring your iPhone to your bedroom.
Correct.
And tell your husband to turn the computer off.
Correct. Check the iPad. And last but not least, I think it's really important to get away on trips with your partner. It could be a weekend, it could be a week, whatever. You know, people have childcare issues, I understand that. But even if it's a night, you know, the first time we went away from our kid, we went to the Santa Monica Hotel.
A staycation.
But it's very important to go and not have the responsibility of the children and to reconnect. I really recommend that people do this at least once, if not more, a year, for a minimum of 1 to 2 nights. If you could do, you know, 2 weekends and a week or whatever you can get away with. But it's really important to get away with your partner and to experience each other without being in that parenting role.
That's great. Those are great tips. So date night once a week, no talking about the kids, no electronics, once a week meeting where you discuss the scheduling, which is so true, so you don't waste your time during the week talking about it.
Correct.
And then get out of town. Find a way. We all have friends. We have family. Get out of town.
Correct.
That was great. I love it. I love Samara. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having
me. And please visit samarafabric.com for some more tips and great ideas about how to live your life to the fullest. And make sure to subscribe here to LA Mom and leave your comments below. What do you do with your partner to make sure that you have quality time together? And we'll see you next time.